What is up, guys? Andrew here, and today I'm back with another video, and I am excited to show you this one because I've been working on this one for a little bit. And also, look, Inception. Here's me, and me. How cool is that? Okay, so what is this video about? This video is how to get Cody on your Fire Stick for free to watch movies, TV shows, live TV, etc. Anything you can happen, it can happen. Okay, so the first thing you want to do on your Fire Stick is to go into settings, go down to My Fire TV, open that, go to developer options, turn on apps from unknown sources. It will be off originally, and then it'll have this. Just click yes, turn it on. Also turn on ADB debugging. Now before we go any further, I do like to mention this is for educational purposes only. Any downloading of movies and selling them is illegal, but streaming them is okay. So as long as you don't download, everything's fine. Now go back to home, go to the search, and search up downloader. Now when you first search it up, it'll show this, and when you click on it, it'll tell you to install it, and once you open it up, you'll get this screen, and click on the URL, and now enter this URL that I'm about to display right here into this box right here. And I suggest using a Bluetooth keyboard, because it is annoying with long URLs to enter every single one with this tiny little remote. After you put in the URL, you just want to hit go, and it'll start downloading. It'll start downloading the Cody application, which you'll need for this video. Every time I turn off a light, I get orange. Every time I turn on a light, I get white. Once this shows up, you want to go down and hit install. And that will install the Cody application, which is everything in this video. Once it's installed, you hit open. And it'll take a little bit on the first startup, but essentially it'll be a fresh copy of Cody 17.6. Once you're on this page, you want to go up to the gear icon, go into that, go into system settings, and then go down to add-ons, go down to unknown sources, click on that, it'll give you this pop-up. You want to click yes, because essentially before you're installing something that's not originally on here, so you'll need to do unknown sources. Once you've done that, go press the back button, go into file manager, go into add source, and click on none, and now you'll want to enter this URL right here into the link. Once you enter that in, you hit OK, go down to highlight it OK, and click on that. Now you want to go back, and back again to the home screen, and scroll down to add-ons. And there'll be some of this. Usually it will say nothing, but if it shows this, go to install from repository, hit the two dots up here, install from zip file, go down to lost Cody, plugin.program.lostbuildswizard.zip. As long as what you're installing is a zip file, then it'll work. Now while we're letting this install, let me tell you more about Cody. Cody is not bad. Cody is just a streaming platform. And what the add-ons that you put onto it, the add-ons that the user puts onto it, is what makes it bad, and that's what has the media jump on it as Cody being a bad thing. And that's why Another thing to note from this build that we're installing right here, Underverse, instead of the other versions being all bulky and janky, this one's actually fast and easy and like super quick to install. I'm doing this right now. I'm making videos. I'm making more videos. I'm trying to do. Enough about me. Let's continue with it. This pops up. Just hit continue. And it'll say build menu or ignore. You want to click build menu. Let it do its thing. Yeah. Go down to fresh install. This is Underverse version 2.9. You click on that. This will pop up. It will be no cancel will be highlighted. You want to go into continue and click on that. This is where it would install. And it's asking you if you want to restore Kodi configuration to default settings. Go over to continue, hit yes. And now it will start downloading. Now the length of this part right here will depend totally on your internet speed and where and which Wi-Fi Fire Stick is connected to, so it varies. Although I do not have fast internet, and yet this build is only gonna be taking like 2 minutes, 3 minutes to download, as it's saying on the ETA right here. So if you have a little bit slow Wi-Fi, but I suggest, like, if you have enough if you have internet speed that's at least 7 megabytes per second, then you'll be good to go, and you can install this and watch content, whatever. It's just recommended because all of this is on the internet, no cable whatsoever. You can actually cut the cable and just use this and different services like Netflix and Hulu and Amazon? What? Well, yeah, Netflix, Hulu, other stuff like that. And actually, I might, if you want a video, I might can show you how to install a Kodi build that gives you free Hulu, free Netflix, and free YouTube Red. So let me know if you want that in the comments below. Or just leave a like on this video, share it. And also, if this video helped you like out at all, or exposed you to something that you never heard of that you're really interested in, then let me know by leaving a like on this video, or comment down below, or share it. You know, I need the exposure. So since the last video, I've gotten a lot of more subscribers since fit to this channel, and thank you for subscribing. And also, I know some of you are because I wrote my YouTube channel link on the end of my presentation in class, and also on the whiteboard in the classroom. So yeah, what's up, teach? Well, we just got an error, and when that happens, I don't know what happens, but you would want to click fresh install again and restart the process. Just to let you guys know, after the 5 times installing this very same version to figure out how to tell you how to install it, I never ran into this problem before. So we're both on the journey today. I'll catch you guys back when something happens. And also my camera battery's dying. Okay, so it asked if I wanted to force close Kodi, and I guess I spent too long not to, you know, messing with it, so it just exited me out. So that is basically done. You're done. You can watch. Look, Underverse. That means it worked. If this shows up when you go into Kodi, that means it worked. You're welcome. You can watch live TV, sports. The Bridge, that's like a service something, kids, documentaries, Wizards, the system settings, you really don't want to mess with that, unless you're an advanced user, which by all means, music, system, also some more settings, power, favorites, movies, TV shows. So that's it. That's the end of the tutorial. But if this video helped you out, make sure to leave a like and share this on any social platform. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat. It'll be down here. Also, subscribe is right there. Videos are over here. My name's Andrew, and I'll see y'all in the next video.